Did you know that there are ethical considerations with keeping bees? This is going to be a really sticky discussion because some of it's opinion and some of it's strong belief and some of it's just flat out true. But we need to talk about these things because as you get into beekeeping, you're going to be facing some ethical dilemmas. And I want to make sure that you're just aware of that as you get into it. Let's just start from the top. If you keep bees, in my opinion, you have an ethical obligation to keep them. Now, what does that mean? If you keep bees, you have an ethical obligation to keep them. Well, a lot of people get bees, throw them in the backyard, and that's sufficient for them. They're bee-havers and not beekeepers. If you keep bees, you should keep bees. So let me explain this a little bit further. And I'm wading into very dangerous territory here because I'm going to bring up something that's incredibly popular right now, this idea of natural beekeeping. I'm not against natural beekeeping. I'm not making any philosophical arguments about natural beekeeping here. But what I will say is that there are some tenets of this that suggest that you shouldn't treat colonies, you shouldn't feed colonies and things like this because it's not what bees need. They're going to survive on their own. If they don't, then that's okay. We'll move on to the next colony. That's not really a philosophy that I share. I believe that if we bring bees under our care and we are, you know, engaged in bee husbandry, in my opinion, we have an ethical obligation to do what's necessary to ensure that the colonies are healthy and productive. I have no problems feeding colonies that look like they are starving. I have no problems applying medications and other treatments to ensure that my colonies maintain health and productivity. I believe this is something I have an obligation to do as a beekeeper. There's another important ethical consideration I need to share with you as you get into your beekeeping endeavor. Something that a lot of people don't think too much about, but it's really, really, really gaining steam. And it's this idea of keeping honeybees in ecologically sensitive areas, especially in areas where honeybees are not native. We're filming this series here in the United States, and in the United States, honeybees are not native. So there's this kind of groundswell amongst some people who are very pro-native bees or pro-environment that honeybees are destroying habitat, honeybees are bad for native bees. I'm going to stop short of saying that. The science at the moment is certainly not supporting those kind of really broad claims about the dangers of honeybees. I would just tell you as a beekeeper, when you're thinking about keeping honeybees in ecologically sensitive areas or areas where your bees could cause a problem for native bee pollinators, that you think twice about placing those colonies there and maybe consider moving those bees elsewhere. This can even be a consideration if you're keeping bees in areas where honeybees are native. For example, Europe, Africa, places like that. And a lot of folks, well, can I just keep a native bee species in an area where they're indigenous? Well, the danger of that is in beekeeping, we tend to amplify the density of colonies that occurs in an area. So maybe honeybees are native where you live, but maybe it's just a colony density of, say, one colony or two colonies or four colonies per kilometer square, maybe per mile square. But we as beekeepers will go in and put 10 colonies and 20 colonies and 30 colonies. So just be aware of this issue because it's beginning to gain traction and steam even in science, and it's something that folks discuss with regularity. But there are also other ethical considerations as well. For example, you're going to be interacting with other beekeepers, and maybe you're placing an apiary that's encroaching on another beekeeper's apiary. You just need to be aware of those types of situations because being a good beekeeping neighbor will really go a long way to help you be a good beekeeper and ensure that your colonies are productive. And while we're talking about being a good beekeeping neighbor, let's branch this out a little bit further and talk about good neighbor guidelines. You're going to keep bees, and you might even have the legal right to put bee colonies in your backyard if you live in a subdivision. But just because you have the right doesn't mean maybe it's the best decision to place your bee colonies in a certain location. Just follow standard good neighbor guidelines and best apiary siting management practices. This will keep your colonies out of areas where people and animals frequent to kind of avoid these situations where you're having to make these ethical judgment calls just because it's my right, should I keep bees here? I'm a strong believer in beekeepers trying to avoid having nuisance apiaries. And if for some reason your colonies are pointed out as being a nuisance, maybe your bees are showing up at the neighbor's pools or bird baths, maybe they're getting stung while they're working in their backyard because they're mowing and your bees going to attack them. If these things arise, don't just double down on your right to keep bees. Consider the ethical obligation that you might have to maybe find a remote apiary site or just move your bees so that everybody's happy. The bees are taken care of, your neighbor's considerations are something you thought about, your own considerations are something you thought about, and where you're making appropriate decisions. Another area where I see a lot of beekeepers kind of push that ethical line a little bit is claims that they make, especially related to human health. There's this entire field of apitherapy, and again, like natural beekeeping, I don't want to wade into it too much because there are some substantiated claims that happen in apitherapy. But I do see a lot of beekeepers making claims that they simply cannot know about their own hive products. Maybe they're honey related to allergies. Maybe come to my apiary, I'll let you get stung so that it will help your arthritis. A lot of these claims are unsubstantiated and are not supported currently by scientific research. That doesn't mean they are or are not true. What I am just cautioning you against is making claims about your colonies, especially medicinal claims about your colonies that you cannot substantiate. Of course, another part of ethics in beekeeping is just simply good beekeeping practices. You want to make sure that as someone who's managing a business, that you're doing it ethically. There's rules and regulations associated with bees and beekeeping all over the place. Are you following those rules? Are you aware of those rules? If you're bottling and selling honey, are you making ethical claims about your honey? Are you labeling it the way that the law says it needs to be labeled? All of these things are things about which you should be aware. I'm not trying to be the morality police in your beekeeping. I'm just wanting to make you aware that you're going to be making ethical judgment calls throughout your beekeeping, and try the best that you can to err on the side of caution. I always say you should be very open to feedback. In fact, you should seek feedback from other experienced beekeepers when you're trying to make these deliberations about things that might be a little bit fuzzy and that you're not sure in your gut if it's the right thing to do.